This is differential phase shift keying modulation and demodulation trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40515. On the panel you can see different blocks are given. Lower block is carrier generator section. Circuit diagram of this section is shown on the panel. So you can study the circuit diagram of carrier signal generator with the help of this block. And this is the another block of DPSK modulator, differential phase shift keying modulator section, and this is the circuit diagram of this section. And output of this section is available between these two points. This is the positive output and this is the ground terminal. This is differential data. You can observe this differential data with the help of CRO. This is data input terminal. You can give the data from the data generator section. This is the data generator section. These are the data output terminal. So you can take the data from these terminals and can give the data to this data input terminal. This is the bit clock input and this is the bit clock output terminal. So connect these two terminals at the time of experiments. Carrier, this is carrier input terminal. This is your carrier output terminal. Carrier generator section generates the carrier signal which is available at this terminal, and connect, we will connect this socket to carrier input socket of DPSK modulator. And this is the demodulator section. This is the input of DPSK and DPSK output. This is the DPSK output terminal. We will connect this socket to this socket for the demodulation of the DPSK signal. And these are the output terminals marked as demodulated output. This is the positive and this is ground terminal. All grounds are connected to each other. And this is the carrier input terminal of demodulator section. And these terminals are the supply terminals, which is internally connected, minus 5 volt, and this is plus 5 volt internally connected supply. So switch on the trainer. We can observe the different signal with the help of CRO. This is CRO, dual channel oscilloscope. And this is the ground lead of this CRO. You can connect this ground lead to any one ground terminal of the panel. And these are the data outputs we observe. We can observe this data output with the help of this oscilloscope. This is the output which is available at Q0 output. This is Q0 terminal. This is next data output Q1. And waveform of this data output is showing in on CRO screen. And this is Q2 output. This is also a data output terminal. And waveform of this data which is available at this Q2 terminal is showing by the oscilloscope. And this is the Q3 terminal. This is another output terminal of data generator section. And this is the waveform of the data which is generated by this data generator and available at the Q3 terminal. And this is carrier output terminal. This is the output terminal of carrier generator section. And this is the, you can observe the carrier signal waveform with the help of the CRO. This is your carrier signal waveform. And this is bit clock output. You can observe the bit clock output by connecting the oscilloscope at the point of bit clock output and ground. And this is the bit clock output waveform. Now we are going to connect data output to use any one data and connect this terminal to data input terminal of DPSK modulator section. This is the bit clock input terminal. Connect this bit clock input terminal to bit clock output terminal of data generator section. This is carrier input terminal. Connect this carrier input terminal to the circuit marked as carrier output terminal of carrier generator section. Now observe the data at channel 1. This is the CRO ground. Connect it to ground terminal, and this is your D0 data, first data socket, and channel 1. Switch on the trainer, and this is the data which is given to the DPSK modulator section, and this is another channel probe of oscilloscope. Connect it to DPSK output terminal, and second channel of the CRO will show the output of this DPSK modulator section, and this is the output waveform of this DPSK modulator section. This is your first channel waveform, this is your second channel waveform, and second channel of oscilloscope is connected between DPSK output terminal of DPSK modulator section, and channel 1 is connected to the data output terminal of data generator section. So channel 1 trace is showing the data input waveform, and channel 2 trace is showing the output waveform or DPSK modulator. So you can study the DPSK modulator waveform. Now connect the second channel probe to the demodulated output terminal, and connect DPSK output, positive output, to DPSK input terminal. Now the output of this section is connected to the demodulator section. This is carrier input terminal. Connect the carrier input terminal to carrier output terminal of carrier generator section. Now carrier is connected, and channel 2, this is the channel 2 waveform, this is channel 1st waveform. Channel 1st is showing the waveform of data input which is given to the data input terminal of DPSK modulator section, and channel 2 showing the waveform of demodulator, output waveform of demodulator section. This is your received signal and this is your input signal. After the modulation and after the demodulation, your waveform, received waveform, this is your received waveform, and this is demodulated output. And you can compare the both input and output waveform with the help of this oscilloscope. Both waveform are same. So this is a study of differential phase shift keying modulation and demodulation. You can study the different circuit diagram with the help of this panel. All circuit diagram of the trainer is given on the panel. So with the help of this panel, you can study the circuit diagram of the trainer. Modulation, the differential signal to the modulating signal is generated using an XOR gate IC3. This is your XOR gate IC3, and a 1 bit delay circuit using IC4. This is your IC4. D flip flop and IC1 is an analog multiplexer to which carrier is applied with and without 180 degree phase shift. To the input of the IC2, differential signal generated by XOR gate IC3 is given to the multiplexer's control signal input. Depending upon the level of the control signal, carrier signal applied with or without phase shift is steered to the output. 1 bit delay generation of the differential signal to the input is created by using a D flip flop IC4. So in the manual, a detailed explanation of modulation and demodulation is given, and this is the carrier generator and data generator explanation. So you can study the detailed explanation of these signals, and these are the different waveforms. This is the waveform of bit clock, this is the waveform of modulating data input, and this is the differential data, and this is carrier waveform, this is DPSK output, DPSK output, DPSK modulator output, and this is the demodulated output, this is your received data. So you can, and this is the procedure of the experiment. Detailed procedure of the experiment is given in our manual. So with the help of this manual and with the help of the procedure which is given in our manual, you can do easily this experiment. And the trainer is differential phase shifting modulation and demodulation trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40515. Thank you.